was very well accepted. And then that was the basis for the Rio Earth Summit. Compared with Rio Plus 20, green economy within the context of sustainable development, poverty eradication, there was no such quote-unquote awareness and marketing of this whole concept. So this is why it got all the country misconceived and did not buy into it. One gentleman then asked, what could be the theme for Rio Plus 30? Now that's very serious. I don't think it's going to be Rio Plus 20, it'll be Stockholm Plus 50. Stockholm Plus 50, where the whole thing is. I believe they are going to be, my own personal view, there will be two issues, and they are related, that the world must confront. One is a question of human security in all its dimension, ecological, economic, social. Just look at how the world, in many parts, crumbling financially, socially, culturally, etc., besides war. So the whole concept of human security, and relating to that is resilience. So I think these two, to me, will be at the top of the agenda for Stockholm Plus 50.
Thank you very much. We have run out of time, so we need to end here. But lastly, if I may, as a moderator, there are the points that I would like to mention, the five or so. First of all, I myself, as I have participated and as I have read the outcome document of Rio Plus 20, I have many the grievances, dissatisfactions, economic and social and sustainability. So these three, sustainability. But in the Japanese, the national preparation, the committee, we have also added cultural sustainability. But this was totally ignored. Cultural sustainability, as I see it, in Asia, this is especially important. To our ancestors, we pay respect, and to our posterity, the future generations, we have expectations and hope. This is to do with our values. The question of values, we need to also grapple with these. Economic and social and environmental sustainability would not be adequate enough. This is what I would like to emphasize, but that was not taken up at all at Rio Plus 20. The second point is, as was discussed earlier, the CBDR. This is, yes, important, very important, but that said, however, at the COP17, the so-called Durban principles, the principle of respective capabilities, RC, it should also be incorporated. I have asserted this in the Japanese National Committee, and it was also included in the Japanese government statement, but that no good reaction, unfortunately, was seen during the Rio Plus 20. My third point is, as somebody asked the question, I believe it was from the Ministry of Education and Science Technology, what was the relevance of side events? As I mentioned at the outset, side events were more important, actually, compared to the intergovernmental consultation, unfortunately. Intergovernmental consultation, unfortunately, there were no good results. But in the side events, what was discussed and debated would be more important this autumn, next year, and the year the following that, there will be very important impact. The civil society, they have held more than 500 side events. And I'm sure there would be major impact on the governments as well. So I hope that we should look at the future, what may be the impact. Now, the fourth point, as was discussed earlier, I believe it was Mr. Shrestha who mentioned a visionary, the global, or national to regional and global. We need to scale up. That I do fully agree. But in addition to that, as was debated earlier, we should also start from local. Local, national, regional, and global. So local community should be emphasized more. We should place at the centerpiece the local community, how to build the better local community. This is what I have asserted for at the Rio Plus 20, and I hope that we will eventually go towards that direction. Lastly but not least, this is a very difficult question, because in the discussion up until now, we were always talking about advanced countries versus developing economies. This is a 20th century paradigm. Looking at the 21st century paradigm, we should not talk in dichotomy, but more like rich and poor. Rich and poor should be the notion, because in the developing economies, there are a lot of potential. And even in advanced countries, there are a lot of poor. So we need to help the poor. The industrialized countries to help the poor in their own countries, but also the rich people in the developing countries should also help their own poor in their own countries. So we should not just discuss in terms of dichotomy between the industrialized countries and the developing countries, but we should talk more about rich and poor. That should be the way to go for our debate. I would like to thank all the speakers. Thank you very much. We should appreciate them with a big hand. Thank you. I have to apologize that we have run out of time, but thank you very much for your participation.
先生、講演者の皆様。
Professor Hirono and discussants, panelists, thank you very much for your cooperation.